and a most pleasant good evening from Lawson State Community College in Birmingham. I'm Brett Elmore alongside Brian Hill for WJLX Sports. And tonight, we are in the Magic City for an Alabama Community College Conference Showdown between the Cougars of Lawson State and your Bevill State Walker College Bears. Brian, just the other night, the Bears coming off a hard-fought loss to Shelton State, 71-66, in a game that late was maybe a one-point ball game, but the Bears were awfully close, but just could not upset the top team in the division.
Yeah, came awfully close, Brett, 67-66 in the last minute of regulation before the Shelton Bucks, the number 17 team in the country, kind of took control and were able to nail their shots. But a good heads-up effort completely and totally by the Bears. There was a side note as Cartarius Evans went out with an injury. Got some good news tonight that he will, in fact, be back next week. It was just a ligament strain in his knee, so no long-term outage for Cartarius. He will be out tonight, but we should see him back by Monday's game.
Very good. We will definitely miss him and his services, but got to keep going on. The next man up philosophy. So we'll have the starting five for you here in just a moment. But the Bears coming in 5-13, 2-7 in the conference. They have lost three in a row, including that game just the other night, Monday night, to Shelton State. On the flip side of the ledger, you have Lawson State, the Cougars. They've lost two out of their last three contests, but they are 11-6 on the season. They're an even 5-5 in conference play. They lost on the road at Marion on Monday night, 90-89 in overtime. And Brian, they have played four games to overtime this season, going 2-2 in extra basketball.
Yeah, obviously they know the pressures of an overtime game very well this season. That game against MMI, Peyton Williams had scored 18 points. He was actually one of five players that scored in double digits during that game. So they do have the ability to score with just about anybody in the starting lineup.
The second best offense in the league. They come in averaging 84.9 a game. So you might as well say 85 points a game they are putting up offensively on the floor. So a tough test tonight for the Bears on the road in Birmingham to take on Lawson State. The Cougars and the Bears set to do action in just a few minutes. Bear basketball, of course, is presented by Pinnacle Bank. We will step aside for a timeout. A 1 minute break, 1 minute, and we'll be back with more Bear basketball in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Mason Boren with Twisted Barley Brewing Company in downtown Jasper, and I do all my banking with Pinnacle Bank.
Hi, my name is Sean Doss from the Cigar Box and Goatee Screen Printing downtown Jasper, and my bank is Pinnacle Bank.
I'm Mike Wigginton, principal at H.L. Wigginton Capital Management, and Pinnacle Bank is my bank.
I'm Robin Reed Allen, chairman of the board of Pinnacle Bank. Come see our team and make Pinnacle Bank your bank too.
Your story starts at Bevill State Community College. Whether you are just starting out or starting over, Bevill State has an opportunity that is right for you. With five locations serving seven counties, you don't have to go far to start your own success story. Plus, with tuition lower than four-year colleges, you won't need to spend more for a great education. Visit us online at bscc.edu to learn about your options for seamless academic transfer and high-demand career tech and health science offerings. Let us help you tell your story.
Welcome back into Birmingham. Time now to check your starting lineup for Bevill State Walker College. As we look at the starting five, tonight they'll go with the number three, Rodney Beckham. Also number five, Gervais Peters will get the start. Number 12, Cornelius Grant, C.J. Grant. R.J. Stevens will get the start tonight, as well as number 30, Malachi Hampton, the starting five for Bevill State Walker College tonight on the road at Lawson.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the On the Shore Five.
The
coming on the campus
public address announcer is now about to announce the starting lineups for both teams as well as have the anthem. So let's step aside here, Woody, for a two-minute timeout. 2 minutes, we'll be back with the tip-off coming up next. This is Bear Basketball on WJLX. All right, just had the national anthem here from Lawson State Community College in Birmingham. The starters being announced to the crowd now by the public address announcer. And Brian, coming up next for the Bears, mark your calendar for Monday night. We'll be back home at the Clem. Gadsden State will be into town. The Cardinal for a... I believe that's a 6 o'clock tip-off coming up Monday night.
I would think so. Always a tough matchup with the Cardinals. No matter what the record is, they always come in to fight hard.
Time for the starting lineups for the Cougars. Let's see who they go with here. Number one, Isaiah Davis. Number two will get the start, Amari Peak Green. Number three, Markel Ani will get the start. Number four, Kyan Healy being announced. And number five, Peyton Williams, the only freshman getting the start here tonight. Four. Lawson State.
And I'll tell you, Brett, with the battle that I'm looking for, particularly that we need to watch, is that battle in the low post tonight with Carterius out. We need to see Stevens and Grant pick up the extra slack on the rebounding duties, and Cam Scott and Jordan Bell when they come in and when their number's called. It's going to be integral for the Bears, as we know the large amount of rebounds that Carterius always records for the Eagle. That's out for tonight.
The Bears already at center court as they are in the road green uniforms. And we're just about set for action here from Birmingham. Lawson is coached by Scott Carter in his first season, has a tremendous resume. And we are underway from Lawson State in Birmingham as the tap controlled by Lawson State. Cougars with a basketball. They work it around the horn. right side. Three ball on the way. It's going to be off the back iron, no good. And in between a double team, going to get the rebound, and the putback is Healy. And once again, another offensive rebound for the Cougars. Peak Green with the basketball. Trying to work off a screen. He will drive in the paint, puts up a floater. It's no good, and down with a rebound comes the Bears and R.J. Stevens. Left side, Peters. Peters will drive on the wing. Backs out, leaves it up top with Rodney Beckham. Beckham hands off now. Hampton top of the key. Back over to Peters. Peters between the legs with a dribble. He will drive in the paint. Bounces off a would-be defender and puts up a circus shot. It's no good. Rebound coming out to Lawson. Whistles, and we got a foul.
Number three, C.J. Beckham is first. He's first.
It's going to be on Beckham.
And Pete Green is the guy to watch for the Cougars. He averages 17.4 points per game as their leading scorer. He's sixth in the conference, Brett, and at the free throw line, an 80% free throw shooter. Sixth.
Davis with the basketball now. He'll hand it off to Anye. Trying the double team. It's going to be stolen away by Peters. Peters in transition. Peters will drive. Puts up the shot. It's good. Lays it up and in. Good for two. 2-0 early going in the contest. 18:31 time to go here in the opening half. With the basketball is Davis. He drives to the paint. Whistles. He's going to be fouled by one of the Bears. See who this is going to be on. It's, that's going to be Malachi Hampton. Peyton Williams shooting two now for Lawson State. Shot up, shot good. 2-1, your score, early going. Bears on top. Second free throw, rims out, no good. And the rebound coming out to the Bears. Beckham with a basketball. Left side to Peters. Top of the circle now, Stevens. He'll leave it off with Hampton. Hampton left side to Peters on the perimeter. Now on the wing. He'll get it out to Stevens. Stevens goes to work. Catches a double team. Kicks out now to Peters. Leaves up top Beckham. He's going to shoot it with eight. Back iron, no good. The offensive board, no. It's going to be into the hands of the Cougars. Cougars with a basketball down. Pete Green with it. Stops his dribble along the baseline. We'll go right side with a pass to Williams. Way outside, almost into the backcourt. It's going to be saved into the hands of Peyton Williams. Cougars with the basketball, 12 to shoot. Pulling up for three is Anye, and the shot is good. Anye with a three gives the Cougars the lead, 4-2. Beckham with the basketball. Back around now to Grant. Hampton. Looking underneath, going to find his man under. He's going to be tied up. And jump ball, the possession arrow will go to the Bears. Bears will inbound baseline here, trailing by two. Early going into the contest from Birmingham. They work it into Grant. Grant backs in. Grant going to work. He's going to put it up over Healy. Shot is up and in. Ties the ball game up at four apiece. Anye with a basketball, stops his dribble, goes right to Healy on the wing. Healy with a hook shot underneath, shot no good. Rebound coming out now to Grant. Grant with a basketball. Grant going to take it all the way to the hoop. He's going to have his shot blocked, but right into the hands of Beckham, who puts it up in the lane and good. 6-4, 16:30, time to go here in the opening half. Backing in with a basketball. Ball is stripped and now the foul is called on one of the Bears. There's three of them there and this is going to be on Stevens.
And Brett, that first shot there, Stevens was able to get a block on that shot. but then the foul resulted on the second shot.
Davis off the inbound, will leave off with Williams. Williams in the paint, stops his dribble, high post. Gonna put up the shot, it's no good. Tipped out of bounds, it'll be Bear basketball. Bears will inbound baseline, go the length of the floor here.
I think Grant is hurt.
Oh no, yeah, he is.
This is a facial injury.
He may have caught an elbow to the nose. He's going to the locker room.
Jordan Bell checks in for him in the meantime.
So Bell is in for the Bears, and he will trigger it in. They are looking, as I believe, maybe some blood on the court.
Yeah, Grant has gone into the locker room, or at least into a trainer's room to be looked at.
They're going to wipe up the floor here. 6-4, your score. Bears out front of the Cougars with 16:09. Time to go here in the opening half from Birmingham. Beckham with a basketball as we get back to action. Going to leave it off with Peters. Peters back over now to Beckham, left side, near side now to Hampton. Around the horn they work it. Far side, Peters, dribble, drive, kick out now. Beckham open for three. He's going to miss it, no good. Whistles, and I believe they're going to charge Peyton Williams with over the back. Yep.
Yep.
Foul loss is number five, Peyton Williams is first, Hickey's first.
So the inbounds, Beckham gets it in. Here's a long three, Malachi Hampton shot good. They're going to say that was a two. Here's a three back the other way. That was good. That was definitely a three by Peyton Williams. Beckham with a basketball now for the Bears. Gonna leave it off with Peters. Top of the key, Peters to the dribble. He will drive in the paint. Whistles, he's tied up again. Possession arrow will go to Lawson State. So the Cougars will have the basketball.
C.J. Grant's back out of the locker room, Brett. Looks like he will be back in action here momentarily.
Onye with the basketball. Top of the key, stops his dribble. Goes right side. A pass to Pete Green. He will drive, but he's going to be fouled going to the bucket. And let's see who this one's going to be on.
This on Hampton.
Yep. It's a second team foul. Bears lead by a point. It's 8-7. As Anye will inbound. He works it in. Three on the way. No good. And going high for the rebound is Jordan Bell for the Bears. Going to leave it off now with Beckham. Malachi Hampton open again for the long ball, three, good.
5 points for Malachi.
Malachi Hampton for three, launched it, and connects. Back the other way with a basketball. Here he is again, shot no good, and the rebound coming out to Lawson State. Anye going, Anye going to put it up and in. It's 11-9 now. Bears out front. Malachi Hampton with a basketball. He'll leave top of the key now. Right side, Peters stops, fires. Goes left side, Beckham for three. No good. Into the hands of Lawson State. The rebound to Peyton Williams. Back over now to Pete Green. Gonna put it up and in off the right side. And that's gonna tie the ball game up at 11 apiece. Slowly up the floor comes Beckham. Gonna hand it off to Peters now. Peters left side with a pass to Hampton. Up top, Bell. As the ball knocked away, comes back up with it. He will drive, try to jockey for position, has the shot blocked. And back the other way with a basketball. Comes Amari, Pete Green. He's gonna be fouled before the shot by number five, Gervais Peters.
Gervais Peters, his first, team fifth.
substitution for the Bears.
Who we got coming in for the Bears?
Grant has checked back in, and Cam Scott is coming in for his first appearance of the game.
So the inbounds coming up. Ani.
Also in for Lawson, State number zero, Nick Howard.
Nick Howard is in for Lawson. Just checked into the game. Averaging 6 points a game. He's a sophomore. Ani. Going to get it in. Here's Howard with a basketball. Leaves it off with Davis. Back inside Williams. He's going to back up. Try to make a move now on Grant. He throws it into the backcourt. It's going to roll out of bounds. It'll be Bear basketball.
It's a nice disruption down there by C.J. Grant.
And the Bears will inbound underneath their own bucket here. As the ball rolled all the way, the length of the floor here. Got 20 on the shot clock. That's what they were setting. Here's Peters off the inbounds. Peters will drive. Peters going to put it up. It's no good, but the foul is called. You heard the whistle. And this is going to go against Omari Peak Green.
And Gervais is down.
That's not a good sign. He's face down along the baseline.
And this is looks a lot worse, Brett. I mean, he is writhing. He's up now.
He took a hard hit. And Coach Cheatham is out there along with a trainer, and they will get him off the floor. And Coach Cheatham seems to be upset about something.
It may have been about the hit that Gervais took.
Yeah, he's not happy at all.
And this, unlike C.J. Grant's, looks like he's woozy.
Yeah, he took a hard hit. He's just below us here.
Maurice Johnson, Skylar Heiss, looks like he's going to check in place of Gervais, but they are putting him in the chair, and he is just he's dizzy, Brett. I mean, it looks like it was bad.
Took a hard bump that time, and now that's going to send. They're going to put Cam Scott at the line to shoot the free throws here with 12:59 to go in the opening half. Scott shot, no good. Second shot coming up. On the way, it's good. Breaking the tie, it's 12-11. Comes Lawson State with a basketball. Onye with it, right side, stops his dribble, goes high post to Howard. Back over now to Williams. Williams stops his dribble, looks for help, finds it at Onye. Eight to shoot, seven, six, Onye at five. At four, kick out pass. Howard for three, no good. Rebound coming out to the Bears as Cam Scott pulls it down. Leaves it with Beckham, back to Scott. Scott drives, puts up a shot in the lane, it's good.
Beautiful drive there by Cam.
Beautiful drive by Cam Scott, and makes it 14-11 now. Bears out front. Nick Howard with the basketball, whistles away from the ball, and we're going to have a foul.
RJ Stevens.
Yep. That is his second foul, 16th foul of the half here, with 12:04 to go in the opening half. Only two fouls for Lawson State. Anye with the basketball. He's going to drive. Kicks it out. Three ball on the way. Got it.
Take it back. 2-point field goal.
2-point basket. They say his foot was just on the line. Scott with the basketball, top of the key. Scott to the dribble. Left side, they work it. Heiss with it. Feeds a bounce pass along the baseline. Going to work underneath. Here's the shot on the way, whistles, as Grant made a move to the bucket. He's going to be fouled.
Number five, Peyton Williams, his second.
Peyton Williams with his second.
For the Cougars, number four.
11 and a half minutes to go here in the opening half. That's going to send Scott back to the line. They will inbound baseline. They work it into Heiss. Heiss to Cam Scott. Left side on the wing. Number 13, Stevens with the basketball. Leaves it with Scott with seven to shoot. Heiss at five. Heiss at four. At three, going to have to put it up. He kicks it out. Shot three, good! C.J. Beckham with a tray as time expires on the shot clock.
That's 5 points for C.J. Beckham tonight.
17-13, your score. Miles with the basketball. The ball is loose. The scrum is on, trying to get a ball back. This is Davis, gonna feed, shot, no good, and the rebound out to the Bears. Beckham with the basketball. Beckham gonna drive. Stevens now, baseline, turnaround jumper off the window and good. Nice move that time. Underneath the bucket to kiss it off the glass. It's 19-13, and the Cougars trying to slow things down a little bit. Miles with the basketball, gonna put it up, no good. Rebound coming out to Heiss. Three ball, Cam Scott. No good off the right side of the rebound out to Lawson State. Howard makes a move, baseline, puts up the shot over Skylar Heiss, but he's fouled by Heiss going to the bucket. Seventh team foul, so keep that in mind. The Bears already with seven fouls, and I tell you, the first shot on the way and good for Howard. It's 19-14.
We've got Jordan Bell checking into the game once again, and Maurice Johnson making his first appearance.
Yep, good to see Maurice in the game. Bears lead by five here. Shot on the way. It's good. Maurice Johnson with the basketball for the Bears. Leaves it off with Bell. Over to Cam Scott. Back to Johnson. Picked up by Howard defensively. He'll set the offense. Goes left side to Scott. Over to Heiss. In the corner for three. It's no good. Fight for the rebound underneath. Bell comes up with it. Bell puts it up and in. ...21-15 your score. 9:23 to go, opening half. In the corner, a three for Lawson State. It's no good as Davis can't get his shot to fall. The rebound underneath, the putback no good. They get another look at it. Cougars for three. No good. Another offensive board. Davis, ball tapped out of bounds by Cam Scott. But Brian, they are getting on it on the boards.
Yeah, 14 team rebounds for the Cougars. Bevill, they don't have to get more physical, but they've got to get more aggressive when going after the rebounds.
Yeah. All right. Here's a long ball from way downtown. The shot is good. From near Vulcan Park. My goodness. Man, he was way out. That makes it 21-18 now. With a basketball, Cam Scott in the corner. Skylar Heiss for three. It's no good. And the rebound coming out to the Cougars. Here's another open look three. Off the front iron, no good. Would not go for Davis. Ball sails out of bounds. It'll be Cougar basketball.
Substitution for Bevill State number three, C.J. Beckham.
C.J. Beckham into the game. Gervais Peters, I'm looking down. He's still nursing that injury, Brett.
Maybe he'll be okay. Lawson State with the basketball here. Healy with it. Looking, underneath the bullet pass to Demetrius Davis. He puts it up and in, and just like that, it's a one-point ball game. Johnson with the basketball for the Bears. Goes left side, Beckham. Over to Cam Scott in the corner. He'll lead back off with Beckham. Near side now, Maurice Johnson. Looking inside, nothing there. Beckham around the perimeter. Johnson now with eight to shoot. Johnson, bounce pass to Beckham in the corner. Back out, Johnson for three. It's no good as time was winding down. Snowbird pass finds the trailer, who puts it up and in. Timeout on the floor. Timeout Bears as the lead has dwindled. And it's now a Cougar lead, 22-21. We will step aside and take a break as well. We'll be back with more Bear basketball after this timeout.
Hello, my name is Ike Baker. I'm a surgeon here in Jasper. I've been using Pinnacle Bank since I came here after residency, and I really enjoyed the local decision-making here and have enjoyed our relationship.
I'm Mike Wigginton, principal at H.L. Wigginton Capital Management, and Pinnacle Bank is my bank.
Hi, I'm Drew Gilbert, managing partner at Tallulah Brewing Company, and Pinnacle Bank is my bank.
I'm Dr. Amanda Darty, and Pinnacle Bank is my bank.
I'm Robin Reed Allen, chairman of the board of Pinnacle Bank. Come see our team and make Pinnacle Bank your bank, too.
We welcome you back to Birmingham, where the Bears trail by a point now, 22-21. Brett Elmore alongside Brian Hill for WJLX Sports. Sebastian Black on the camera for the live feed and stream. Woody Wilson back to studio, our producer and engineer. Here's Bell with the basketball for the Bears. It's going to be knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Howard as we're back to action. Looks like Scott will inbound side court in front of the Cougar cheerleaders. With the basketball is Beckham. He launches the tray, it's good.
8 points now for CJ Beckham, Brett.
The Bears reclaim the lead. 24-22, but not for long. A three-pointer by number 11, Kennedy Miles.
Trading artillery shots now.
Feed underneath, Bell gonna be fouled underneath by number four, Healy. Got a battle tonight in Birmingham. That's gonna send Jordan Bell to the line. He is a 58% free throw shooter. Shot is no good.
Epps is going to check into the game for the Bears. Johnson will leave.
So Epps in there. One more shot coming up now for Jordan Bell. The freshman eyes the bucket. Shot on the way. And it will fall home for him. Good.
Tie ball game.
Yep, we're tied at 25 with 6.5 minutes to go in the opening half from Birmingham. Three ball, Howard on the way, no good for Lawson. Rebound, Jordan Bell. He rips it away and gets it off to Epps. Epps with the basketball, left side. Cam Scott makes a move, baseline. Shot is blocked out of bounds. So now, Beckham will inbound. He'll get it into Epps. Epps to the dribble. Way outside the perimeter. Leaves it off with Beckham, back to Epps now. 10 to shoot. Epps stops his dribble, leaves it off now with Beckham. 8 to shoot.
Knocked out of bounds by the Cougars. Brad, just 4 seconds on the shot clock with the inbound for the Bears.
Not a lot of time. So let's see if Beckham can work it in. He gets it in. Here's the shot from Cam Scott. No go! My goodness, the follow-up dunk is there, though. Jordan Bell. Hello.
What an exclamation mark by Jordan to throw that down on the rebound.
27-25 Bears. With a basketball loss at stake. Shot off the back iron, no good. Rebound coming out to Bell. Bears with the basketball. Beckham gonna leave it with Bell. He drives, shot blocked, and he's fouled.
Jordan Brett is really starting to insert himself in this game. He's got 5 points and five rebounds, and that's just in limited time.
Yeah. And it's good to see him somewhat take a leadership role on the floor. You could kind of tell he's just a freshman.
But he's a very physical specimen.
Yeah, he is.
Athletic, got a strong upper body. He's the type of player that we're going to be looking forward to seeing for these next two seasons.
Yeah.
Hampton in, and he will relieve Grant.
One more shot coming up for Jordan Bell. It's 28-25. Bears on top. Appreciate you folks listening to Bear Basketball on WJLX. Back iron, no good. And the rebound to Purcell. He'll leave it off with Anye. Back around the horn, Davis. A long jumper, no good. And the rebound being fought for underneath. Whistles.
Jump ball.
Jump ball. It'll be Bear Basketball. Off the inbounds, here comes Epps to Hampton. Into the front court, working to the goal to our right here. Here's Epps. Way outside as the Bears lead by three. Back around Epps with a basketball. Here comes a shot from the high post, no good from Bell. And the rebound cleaned up by Lawson State. Purcell with a basketball. Leaves off with Anye. He's motioning the offense. Back over to Purcell. Right side perimeter. Looks. Finds Stoudemire, and he's going to have his pocket picked. But fouled. Stoudemire is going to foul Jordan Bell as he got his pocket picked that time.
That's 16 fouls now, Brett, so the Cougars are closing in on the 1-1. And there hadn't been any fouls since Bevill landed on number 7.
Yeah, they've kind of eased into this ball game, and now we have a momentary delay. Back to action now. Epps with a basketball with 4:20. Time to go here in the opening half. Here's a feed, looking underneath. And nice job that time by Cam Scott. He was losing the basketball out of bounds. He wisely knocked it off one of the Cougars. And now the Bears will work it in. Bell has his shot blocked by Stoudemire. Here's Purcell with the basketball now for the Cougars. High up top to Anye, whistles now. Away from the basketball. And we got a foul on Bell. So that'll send number 20, Trayvon Stoudemire, to the line. Shot on the way, front half of the 1-1 is good. 28-26, your score. Second shot on the way. It's good. 28-27. 1 point advantage for the Bears. Oh, no.
Lawson State ball.
Epps turns the ball over.
On the inbound.
On the inbound. Goodness gracious. So Lawson will inbound. Here's number three with the basketball, Anye. Picked up by Epps defensively. Gonna lob a pass over now to his teammate. This is Davis, gonna put up the shot. It's no good. Bell away with a rebound.
He's got 6 and 6, 6.6 rebounds, Brett.
And leave off now with Beckham, who puts it in off the right side.
Double digits for CJ, 10 points.
Whistles, offensive foul. Back the other way we go.
And who again? Jordan Bell on the play, taking that charge.
Yeah, Jordan's having a great afternoon or evening so far. So Epps will try the inbound again. Baseline. He will work it in to Beckham. Back over now to Epps. 30-27, 3:18 to go here in the opening half. Malachi Hampton, way up top, gonna put up the three, it's no good, ball tipped around. Cam Scott pulls down the rebound though. The offensive board, here's Epps, left side perimeter. Epps will leave off now with Beckham. CJ gonna direct traffic here, 9 to shoot. He's gonna kick out Epps, baseline. Here's a jumper, good for Jordan Bell.
Now 8 points for Jordan.
Nice shot along the baseline. Anye with it. Gonna leave way up high to Davis. Whistles, traveling with the basketball.
Substitution for Los Angeles number 2, Will Lowry, Deep Green.
So the Bears will have it. Leading 32-27. With 2.5 minutes to go in the opening half, a pretty good half of basketball for the Bears, Brian.
Absolutely, and once again, this emergence of Jordan Bell powering a lot of what we're seeing.
Left side, Beckham gonna step in, gonna put up the long deuce, good. C.J. Beckham.
Now with a dozen, as he's doing a lot of contributing tonight.
Yes, he is, from just inside the perimeter. Here's a feed, right side on the wing. Going to work, shot blocked.
Cam Scott.
Cam Scott back the other way. Malachi Hampton ahead, kicks it back outside. Looks, finds Epps, left side to Hampton. Baseline move, kicks it out again. Beckham to Hampton. And he turns over the basketball. Back the other way in transition, ball is stripped. Bell comes up with it for the Bears.
Beautiful move there by C.J. Beckham.
Beckham with the basketball. Stops, going to find right side. Leaves it with Hampton. Cross court to Epps, top of the key, Beckham. 1:20 to go here. Opening half in Birmingham. Jordan Bell with the basketball with 7 to shoot. Drives, kicks it out, Epps. Back over now, Beckham, gonna launch, it's off the mark, no good. Lawson away with a rebound, it's Healy. Anye with the basketball. Right side perimeter, 1 minute to go in the half. Bears lead 34-27. Here's a three on the way, it's no good. Down with a rebound is Cam Scott. Whistles, he's traveling with the basketball. Traveling with the basketball. And back the other way we go. Lawson will have it. Isaiah Davis will inbound baseline. 48 seconds left in the opening half. Anye gonna feed to Davis. He gets his shot to fall. And the foul is called.
Foul on Belsay number 30. Malachi Hampton is third. Team's 90.
So Hampton's got three, Brian.
Yep. And that's tough because he's got 5 points and has been making some good contributions tonight.
Davis will go to the line to try to make this a 4-point game. He eyes the bucket. Shot's going to rim out on him. No good. And away with the rebound comes Jordan Bell for the Bears. Bears with the basketball, going to leave it now with Beckham. About a 10-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. 30 seconds to play. Here's Hampton. A no-look pass is going to go out of bounds. Last touched by the Bears, they say.
C.J. Grant checking into the game. He will relieve Malachi Hampton.
So with 21 seconds left, the shot clock is off. Lawson could work for the final shot of the half, and probably will. Omari Peak-Green, who has been pretty much silent here in the opening half with a basketball. 5-4, he drives in the paint, puts up the shot, no good. As time expires, that is the end of the opening half of action. Your score, Bevill State Walker College 34, Lawson State 29 from Birmingham. We are going to take a break. Going to send it back to our studios in Jasper. Woody Wilson is standing by. A 3-minute timeout. 3 minutes, and we're back with more Bear basketball on WJLX.
Hi, guys. I'm Dr. Martin Roberts, owner of Jasper Veterinary Clinic. 3 years ago, when I set out to open my own clinic, Pinnacle was my bank of choice to help that dream become a reality. Recently, when we needed to expand and had the opportunity to acquire property adjoining to ours, I made one call to Wayne, and he set those wheels in motion. If you have banking needs, give Pinnacle a call.
Hello, everyone. I'm Drake McKenzie from All South Land and Timber. We've been banking with Pinnacle Bank for over 25 years. The customer service at Pinnacle Bank is first class. We highly recommend banking with Pinnacle Bank for all of your financial needs.
I'm Robin Reed Allen, Chairman of the Board of Pinnacle Bank. Come see our team and make Pinnacle Bank your bank too.
Your story starts at Bevill State Community College. Whether you are just starting out or starting over, Bevill State has an opportunity that is right for you. With 5 locations serving 7 counties, you don't have to go far to start your own success story. Plus, with tuition lower than 4-year colleges, you won't need to spend more for a great education. Visit us online at bscc.edu to learn about your options for seamless academic transfer and high-demand career tech and health science offerings. Let us help you tell your story.
Because you gave. The Walker College Foundation has provided almost $3 million in scholarship funds.
Because you gave, I can become a nurse and save lives.
Because you gave, I will help shape the minds of future generations with a career in education.
Because you gave, I am able to go to school debt-free while becoming an esthetician. So thank you so much.
Because you gave, these scholars will change the world around them and make a difference in our community for generations to come. Thank you for your support.
Donate today. For more information, log on to WCFDN.org.
Welcome back, everybody, to WJLX's broadcast of Bevill State basketball, presented by Pinnacle Bank, where the Bears lead at the half over Lawson State, 34-29. Sebastian Black here, joined by Brian Hill at the half. Brian, we've seen a pretty good Bevill State team here in this first half. Back on Monday they played against number 17 state or 17th nationally ranked team in the state or in the nation, Shelton State, and they played pretty good ball against them, and they brought the same action tonight here at
Lawson State. How are those numbers looking so far at the half?
Well, C.J. Beckham is leading everybody in scoring with 12 points. Bass, I'm sure that you've seen this. The emergence tonight of Jordan Bell has been one of the big stories. He, along with C.J., are just getting the job done. Jordan's got 8 points, 7 rebounds, and a steal. So, fabulous night for him. Malachi Hampton is another story in this. He's got 5 points, chipping in, and really, I think, only his second start on the year. He's been making some plays. C.J. Grant has 4 points. He has a couple of rebounds. Cam Scott with 3 points and 3 rebounds. And then Gervais Peters, who unfortunately we've seen go out with an injury, and this looks like it's a tougher injury, unlike Cornelius Grant, who just went out for a few moments with a little nosebleed. Gervais's been out, and I've been watching him on the sidelines. He's definitely hurt. Don't know if he'll be returning or not, but Gervais just had 2 points. Me and Brett highlighted in the pregame, one of the things that we'll be watching is the rebounds with Carterius out with injury through Sunday and should be back for Monday. We really wanted to watch how the rebounding would do. It's only a +2 rebound differential between the two teams. Lawson State just has 20 rebounds team-wise to Bevill's 8. So not that bad of a rebounding battle. If the Bears can continue this type of play, though, I think they could pull away. We just don't want to see what we saw against Southern Union, where the 5-point differential ends up a loss at the end of the game because of losing intensity.
You're right. And speaking of Jordan Bell, how about that nice little dunk he had right there? That was beautiful right there. He signed up.
Beautiful, absolutely gorgeous dunk on the offensive rebound putback. I tell you what, he is just doing superb tonight. We've seen various spurts from Jordan throughout this season, but he's really taken hold of this game and taken charge along with C.J. Beckham. C.J.'s getting a lot done on the outside, whereas Jordan Bell is going and doing a lot on those low post battles.
Yeah, and speaking of injury-wise, looks like Gervais is pretty seriously injured here, looks like, but you know, Bevill State can't have too many more injuries. You know, yeah. Carterius out, you know, through what looks to be Sunday, hopefully back on Monday. But if Gervais, you know, depending on how severe Gervais Peters is injured, you know, they can't really take many more blows there on injuries.
No, the deficit for injuries is already racked up enough. Luckily, and I didn't share this with you, but it bears repeating, when I spoke with Coach Cheatham before the game, he had told me that it was a ligament sprain for Carterius, and he will expect it to be back on Sunday, so we should see him by next game, in which obviously we wish he was back in this game for us, but much better news than, let's say, a tear or, you know, any kind of damage that could lead him out for a long time.
You're right. Well, at the half here, Bevill State leads 34-29 over the Lawson State Cougars here on the campus of Lawson State. We're going to take a 3-minute break here, come back and walk around the area here and recap the Walker County basketball tournament that was last week. We'll recap that and maybe some more here. 3-minute break, and we'll be right back here with WJLX's broadcast of Bevill State Basketball presented by Pinnacle Bank. Welcome back, everybody, to WGLX's broadcast of Bevill State Basketball, presented by Pinnacle Bank, where here at the half, the Bears lead 34-29 over the Lawson State Cougars here on the campus of Lawson State. Well, Brian, take a look at the walk around the area here. Is last week, actually a week week from today, last week, we were over in Wildcat Country where we had the Walker County Basketball Tournament and started play on Thursday for us, the broadcast. And talk about championship Saturday. We had the JV boys, the varsity girls, and the varsity boys action, where Oatman and Cordova squared up in the JV boys action. The Oatman Wildcats took that one in the JV varsity boys, or JV, my bad, JV boys. So the Wildcats took the Walker County Championship on the JV boys side. And how about the varsity girls? Coach Blevins and the Dora Bulldogs for the second straight year are the Walker County champions there for the varsity girls. And then for the varsity boys action, the main event of that Saturday evening was the Oatman Wildcats and the Cordova Blue Devils, as what we saw, a pretty good matchup between the two, and Cordova takes home the Walker County championship there to bring it back home to Blue Devil country. But Brian, we had a pretty good time over there in Wildcat country, as pretty good 3 days of Walker County basketball action.
Yeah, for the most part, most of the games were very competitive. We saw a lot of good action that eventually strung together, though, and on the varsity side, ended up with champions repeating again, both for the Dora Bulldogs on the girls' side and the Cordova Blue Devils on the boys' side. But it was great overall action that we saw in our 3 days of broadcasting, and it was a real pleasure to watch it. Always fun to watch Walker County's granddaddy of them all.
And speaking of, we got Bevill State here tonight on the road at Lawson State as they lead 34-29 here. Don't forget, they lost to Shelton State back on Monday, 71-66. As we said, they played a really, really good ball game against the number 17 team in the nation. But for you Bears fans, don't forget, they will, I believe, be at home next Monday versus Gadsden State. Mm-hmm. Believe that is a 7 o'clock tip off, if not earlier.
Yep, we'll be back home, and Gadsden State, always a competitive opponent, regardless of the records. Always a tough draw for the Bears.
You're right, Brian. But the Bears lead here 34-29, and that's going to conclude your halftime here at Lawson State, where the Bears lead 34-29. We are a minute and 10 away from the second half. We're going to take a one-minute break and be right back here with Bevill State Basketball, presented by Pinnacle Bank.
All right, welcome back to Birmingham, where we're just about set for the second half of action. And Brian, looks like Peters did not warm up during the half, so it looks like he's probably going to be out for the remainder of the game.
Yeah, it looks like it may be an eye injury. Could be something around that eye socket, but he's still down.
Here's a drive as we get back to action. Shot no good by the Cougars. And instantly a fourth foul on Malachi Hampton.
Bad news for Malachi, as you've got to think that that'll take him out of the game.
Yeah. Inbounds coming up as a sub coming in. You're absolutely correct. Skylar Heiss will come in, and he's going to spell Hampton, who within the opening 9 seconds of the half has picked up his fourth foul. Inbounds coming up. They work it in to Onye. Near side perimeter. He will drive, kick out pass, open look, three from the corner. No good, but the long rebound out to Healy. It goes out of bounds. It'll be Bear basketball. Brett Elmore and Brian Hale here for WJLX Sports. Here's a three from Heiss on the way. It's on the way, no good. And the rebound coming out now to Lawson State. Isaiah Davis pulls it down. Pete Green with the basketball. To the dribble, working. Going to put up a shot. It's no good, but the foul's going to be called on Cam Scott.
So that's two quick ones already, and we're not even a minute into the second half.
And that's going to be Cam's first. And to the line, Omari Pete Green, who is an 80% free throw shooter. Shot on the way and good. He's their leading scorer, as Brian mentioned, 17 points a game, but he is nowhere near that. That's only his third point. As he hits the second, it's good, 34-31. Back the other way with the basketball. Cam Scott going to leave off now with Stevens, who will put up the shot. It's no good. Off the back iron, and the rebound up. Going to be knocked away. Beckham. Beckham steals it away. Beckham going to put it up and off the window. Count it, and the foul.
Great play there by CJ. Brett, that's his 14th point, having a chance to get himself 15 here on the and one.
Go to the line to shoot free throws here. Bears lead by five as Beckham tries to extend it to six. Shot is no good, and the rebound coming out to the Cougars. Onye pulls down the board. He has the basketball. Into the front court with a dribble. Picked up by Beckham defensively. As the Bears are in a man-to-man defense, he stops his dribble, looks, finds Davis left side. Picked up by Heiss defensively. High post. They go to shoot. No good. Whistles and a shot clock violation as Williams could not get the shot to draw iron. And the Bears will inbound baseline. They'll work it into Beckham, into the front court quickly. He'll leave it now with Stevens. Back around Heiss. Around the perimeter they go. Cam Scott right side. Scott bounces a pass over to Stevens. He'll make a move along the baseline. Kick out pass, Heiss. Heiss will drive. Leaves it now. Shot no good. Stevens with a tip no good. Stevens takes a hard hit. He is up barely. Back the other way with the basketball, and the three is good. Omari Pete Green makes it 36-34. Heiss with the basketball to Cam Scott, right side perimeter. Picked up by Onye defensively. Leaves it with Stevens, who has a noticeable limp a little bit off that fall. Heiss top of the key. Near side to Beckham. They'll skip a bounce pass back inside. Kick out, Heiss with three to shoot. Heiss going to have to put it up. Ball is loose. Lawson stayed away with a basketball. Omari Pete Green with a basketball. Going to work off a screen. goes high post, puts up a shot off the back iron, no good. And the rebound coming out to Cam Scott and the Bears. Beckham with a basketball. Top of the key, he'll go to work. He'll kick out now. Here's Heiss, open for three. Oh, it rims out on him, no good. And the rebound coming out to Lawson State. Ball is loose as it's knocked away from behind. Lawson back away with it. Williams with a basketball, left side picked up by Scott. He will try to back in and has the ball knocked away. Knocked away and out of bounds.
Maurice Johnson's going to check in for Heiss. Brett, the Bears are really becoming lapsadaisical on their rebounding, unlike what we saw in the first quarter. It's a plus eight differential right now, rebounding for the Cougars.
Isaiah Davis with the basketball, left side. He drives on the wing. Going to put up a shot high off the glass and good. We're tied at 36. 16-20, time to go here in regulation. Whistles. We got a foul away from the ball on Peyton Williams. That'll be his third. And Demetrius Davis will check back in for the Cougars. Beckham will inbound. He'll trigger. He gets it in now to Stevens. To Maurice Johnson. They work it around to Beckham. Thought about the alley-oop. Now we'll pull up, take the three, and connect!
17 points now for C.J.
C.J. Beckham. Good-looking shot. Drains the tray. Back the other way we go. The shot is no good. And the rebound coming out to Cam Scott. Scott in transition. Right side good with a shot on the wing. And the Bears lead 41-36. On the wing, back the other way. Shot good. Demetrius Davis makes it 41-38. We got a timeout on the floor. Timeout Lawson State. We'll take one as well. With 15:36 to go in the ball game, we'll be back with more Bear basketball in a moment.
Hi, I'm Mason Boren with Twisted Barley Brewing Company in downtown Jasper, and I do all my banking with Pinnacle Bank.
Hi, my name is Sean Doss from the Cigar Box and Goatee Screen Printing downtown Jasper, and my bank is Pinnacle Bank.
I'm Mike Wigginton, principal at H.L. Wigginton Capital Management, and Pinnacle Bank is my bank.
I'm Robin Reed Allen, chairman of the board of Pinnacle Bank. Come see our team and make Pinnacle Bank your bank too.
Welcome back. Bear basketball is presented by Pinnacle Bank. It's live on WJLX 101.5 FM. And, of course, streaming live on our social media platforms, whether it be Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. Well, 15:36 to go here in the second half. The Bears holding on to a 41-38 lead. And, Brian, they played well against Shelton the other night, the top team in the league. Mm-hmm. Couldn't get over the hump. Maybe they can tonight.
Yeah, let's hope that they do. They've just got to keep going, and they've got to pick up the rebounding, Brett.
Beckham with the basketball near side. Going to go Cam Scott. Shot. Got it. Connects. From the high post, that makes it 43-38 now. Bears out front.
That's 7 points now for Cam.
Anye with the basketball. Going to go left side. He's going to try the three. It's going to be short. And the rebound coming out to Stevens. Stevens running with it. Trying to find Beckham and has his pass intercepted. Back the other way. The alley-oop is up and good. Demetrius Davis. My goodness. Dunks the basketball. It's 43-40. Beckham to Maurice Johnson to Cam Scott. Scott now will drive in the lane. Going to put up a floater and gets it to fall.
9 points now for Cam.
9 points with a floater in the lane. It's 45-40. Lawson State with a basketball. Anye. Gonna go right side with a pass to Healy. Back around Big Davis now. Trying to back up on RJ Stevens. Now he'll leave. Whistles back the other way we go. This is going to be on the big man, Demetrius Davis. Only his first, third team foul of the half. As R.J. Stevens will inbound side court here. Here's Maurice Johnson with the basketball, right side perimeter. Top of the key, they'll go Cam Scott. Kick it back out to Beckham. Beckham on the left side, stops on the wing. Gonna be double teamed. Whistles, we have a jump ball. And the Bears will have possession. 13:58 to go here in the second half. They work it in to Maurice Johnson. Johnson to the dribble. Leaves it with Cam Scott, right side perimeter. Scott back over now to Johnson. Three to shoot, got to shoot it. He does, a desperation shot. It will not go. Oh, the rebound, the offensive board. Coming out now to C.J. Beckham. Leaves it off now with Cam Scott. Top of the circle. Scott looks. Going to fire to Stevens.
Traveling.
Yep.
Lawson State ball.
Took too many steps. Back the other way. Off the turnover, Anye. We'll await the inbounds pass from Davis.
Here comes Jordan Bell. He's going to check in for C.J. Grant. Bell, as we mentioned, 8 points, seven rebounds, and a steal.
Anye with the basketball. Left side perimeter. Directing traffic, leaves it off with Pete Green, top of the key. Picked up by Scott defensively. He'll drive on the paint. Let's see. Oh,
They're going to tag Cam Scott.
Yep. May have heard his second, third team foul of the half. Anye will inbound baseline. Gets it in to Peak Green. To Davis, the big man, going to put up a floater in the lane, and it's good. 45-42, 12:50, time to go here in the second half. Bears with a three-point advantage. Jordan Bell with the basketball, who had an excellent opening half. Turnaround jumper, no good. And the rebound going to be fought for. Anye going to come up with it, it looks like. Excuse me, that's Pete Green. Green with the basketball. Kick out now, left side. Here's Anye. He will drive. Back to Pete Green. Baseline jumper. Catches nothing but air. It's no good. And out of bounds, it'll be Bear basketball.
Epps checking in. He will relieve Scott.
Scott will take a breather here and go to the bench. Sit beside Coach Cheatham. Don't forget, Bears back in action Monday night at home against Gadsden State. As the Lawson State coach up off the bench, coached with Billy Donovan. He's got a very impressive resume in his first season at Lawson. Near side with the basketball is Beckham. Beckham going to leave it off with Epps. Now right side. Here's the shot, no good. And the rebound coming out to Lawson State. Under 12 to play. Anye will drive. Whistles. We got a foul. And this is going to be on Maurice Johnson.
Fourth team foul, Brett, for the Bears.
Howard will check in, and Kennedy Miles for Lawson State. Inbounds, they work it to Davis. Here's a shot, right side, no good. And the rebound out to the Bears. Maurice Johnson away with the basketball. Quickly out front, leaves it off with Stevens. Looking, going to go back way outside near the timeline to Beckham. He'll reset. He'll drive along the baseline. Puts up the shot. No good. Down with the rebound is Nick Howard for Lawson State. Whistles now. He steps on the baseline. I do believe an out of bounds. No. They're going to say it's Lawson basketball.
Turnovers are starting to hurt bad, Brett. It's it's a three-point differential for the Bears, but still, you think of the lost opportunities.
Yeah, that's very true. Here's Davis with the basketball. Going to leave off with Anye. Left side, picked up by Maurice Johnson defensively. Back over to Davis now. Near side, Healy. Anye to Healy. Working it around the horn. Here's the three from the corner. Nothing but air. Howard going to have a shot blocked as time expires. Shot clock violation. Out of bounds. Good defense, Bears. And the Bears will inbound baseline. Stevens going to do so. I think he got something in his eye.
Good possibility. Cam Scott checked in, and also Skylar Heiss is going to be checking in and here momentarily.
Next dead ball. Here's Maurice Johnson with a basketball. Maurice going to look, find Stevens. Kick out now. Beckham for three. No good. Long rebound coming out to Isaiah Davis for Lawson State. And another foul is called, and this one's going to be on R.J. Stevens.
Number 13, R.J. Stevens. His third team's fifth.
Five team fouls now, Brett.
Yep, with 10:36 to go here in the second half.
C.J. Beckham checks out, Brett. Fabulous night thus far for him, 17 points.
Yeah, great night. Here's the ball knocked away. Out of bounds, it'll be Bear basketball. Good defense that time, a good hustle from Skylar Heiss. He'll inbound side court, right in front of Coach Cheatham and the Bear bench. Looks to get it in, he will get it in to Stevens. Leaves it off with Johnson now, way outside. Gonna run the offense, running the point. Leaves it off with Heiss. Way outside now, Cam Scott. Going to drive with seven to shoot. Heiss going to try to feed back in the corner. With three to shoot, it goes out of bounds. It'll be Bear basketball, but like I mentioned, only three to shoot.
This is going to be a pressure cooker, Brett, to see if they can get it in and get off a good shot.
Let's see what they work up here. They're going to get it in to Bell, who has his shot blocked from behind and fouled. Good job that time. Bell drew the double team and drew the foul as time was winding down on the shot clock. That's not what you wanted if you were a Lawson State fan.
No, uh-uh. He's going to have a chance to get up 10 points on the night.
A 58% free throw shooter, though, and he misses the shot. It's no good. He'll have another one coming. Jordan Bell, his second shot on the way. Short, no good. And the rebound coming out to Peyton Williams for Lawson State. Out front to Miles. Back over now to Williams. Around the horn they go, Davis. Far side perimeter picked up by Heiss defensively. Bear basketball is presented by Pinnacle Bank on WJLX. Here's the top of the key. Shot will bounce around. It's no good. Foul underneath. Are they going to call this on Stevens? I think they are.
Yeah, and that's going to be his fourth foul, Brett.
Yeah, that's
so
what I was afraid of.
I'm afraid he'll have to check out as well.
Bears in foul trouble here, holding on to a three-point lead. 16 foul of a half. They work it into Howard, who's open for the shot. No good. Bell down with a rebound for the Bears. Going to leave it out with Maurice Johnson. Back over now to Cam Scott. Leaves it with Johnson. Around the perimeter they go. Far side, Stevens. Back over to Heiss. Top of the circle. Plenty of time to shoot. Heiss at 10. Alley-oop was looking for number 15, Cam Scott. But just off of the fingertips of Scott and out of bounds. Well, Brian, you have to have smart possessions, too.
Mm-hmm.
When we're closing in on 9 minutes to go here in the ball game, and you're holding on to a three-point lead.
Well, it's a lot of this has been the turnovers and the missed free throws, Brett, that's been also killing for Bevill. they've got a three-point lead, but you think of all the missed opportunities that could have come up with this, and it's got to be biting Coach Cheatham to see it.
Yep. Miles with the basketball, has Davis now. He will drive, going to take it all the way to the rim. Shot no good, though. And a rebound coming out to the Bears. Maurice Johnson going to leave now. Bell, he's going to be fouled underneath. It's going to be on Nick Howard. Isaiah Davis gets a call. So, fifth team foul, and I believe this is going to send DeBell back to the line.
It is. Let's see if he's more successful on these attempts.
One would hope. Jordan Bell eyes the bucket. First shot on the way. It is up, and it is good. Hit the back iron, hit the front iron, and took a friendly roll in.
Had C.J. Beckham and Grant also check in to the game.
Second shot coming up, 46-42. Rims out on him, no good. Missed opportunities for the Bears here. They are now pressing. Lawson, they're going to turn it over. Bears have the basketball back the other way as the press works. Beckham, right side perimeter. 8:25, time to go here in the ball game. Bears up 46-42. Maurice Johnson with the basketball. Gonna go right side. Beckham drives, kick out. Maurice with eight, gonna put up the shot, good!
Maurice Johnson.
Left side, drains it, makes it 48-42. 8 minutes to go in Birmingham. Cross court, Davis. In the corner, Howard. Picked up by Beckham defensively. He'll drive past Beckham. Put the shot up and in, and the foul is called.
They're going to call this on C.J. Beckham, which it's only his second foul, Brett, but this is a shooting opportunity.
Nick Howard will go to the line. One of the best free throw shooters on the team. 87% from the charity stripe. And the shot is money. Good. 48-45 whistles.
And now we've had a press on Bevill, but it goes against the hopes of Lawson as that's a drawn foul.
Davis going to be charged with his third. And now the Bears will march up the floor here. And inbound.
They're saying that's the seventh foul, I believe.
Oh, is it?
Well, it's showing seven.
Well, that's on us. Yeah, it's 16 foul.
Okay. My bad.
It's quite all right.
Oh no,
the inbound is stolen, and it's going to be put up and in by number five, Peyton Williams. Timeout, Bears. Up by a point, 48-47. The 6 point for Peyton Williams. We will take a break and return to Birmingham. A full timeout, 60 seconds. We'll be back with more Bear basketball presented by Pinnacle Bank in just a moment.
Starts at Bevill State Community College. Whether you are just starting out or starting over, Bevill State has an opportunity that is right for you. With 5 locations serving 7 counties, you don't have to go far to start your own success story. Plus, with tuition lower than 4-year colleges, you won't need to spend more for a great education. Visit us online at bscc.edu to learn about your options for seamless academic transfer and high-demand career tech and health science offerings. Let us help you tell your story.
Because you gave. The Walker College Foundation has provided almost $3 million in scholarship funds.
Because you gave, I can become a nurse and save lives.
Because you gave, I will help shape the minds of future generations with a career in education.
Because you gave, I am able to go to school debt-free while becoming an esthetician. So thank you so much.
Because you gave, these scholars will change the world around them and make a difference in our community for generations to come. Thank you for your support.
Donate today. For more information, log on to wcfdn.org.
back, everybody. We are back live in Birmingham. Here's a drive. Jordan Bell shot no good. Rebound Stevens. Kick out. Beckham for three. Back on. It bounces out no good. A rebound coming out to Lawson State. Bear basketball presented by Pinnacle Bank. Brett Elmore alongside Brian Hell for WJLX Sports. Here's a dribble drive. Kick out now. Three ball on the way. No good. Rebound being fought for, being tapped around. Finally, let's see who's going to come up with it. The Bears will. Here's Jordan Bell to the glass. No good. Rebound, Lawson State. My goodness. 6:50, time to go here in the ball game. Kennedy Miles with the basketball. Going to go left side to Davis. Pulls up on the wing. Going to put up the shot. No good. Bell down with a rebound for the Bears. Out front, Maurice Johnson into the front court. Johnson, right side perimeter. Picked up by Miles defensively. Here's a pass to Stevens. Going to put up the shot. No good. He's going to be fouled by number 11, Kennedy Miles.
This is actually Grant.
I'm sorry. My apologies to Mr. Grant. For some reason, I've been getting Stevens and Grant mixed up.
That's five for C.J. Grant. Cam Scott's going to be checking in the game for Trinity Epps.
Okay. Here comes C.J. Grant with his second shot. 49-47, 6:22 to go here in the ball game. Shot on the way, back iron no good. Ball tipped around, out of bounds. It's going to be Lawson basketball.
So you say this coach coached in Gainesville?
Yeah, he did.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, he did. He coached in Gainesville with your with your pride down there.
Yeah, bad move.
Back the other way with the basketball. Brian's a huge Gator fan, if you can't tell.
Yeah.
Here's Adye with a basketball.
That, and I miss my eczema.
All right. Here's a drive on the wing. Back around the horn. Pete Green with a basketball. Six to shoot. Defense collapses in. Shot blocked.
Oh, beautiful.
By Bell. Shot blocked again by Bell. As time expires on the shot clock, they're going to charge him with a foul. Oh, my goodness. But I tell you what. He may have fouled him, but you got to give that kid A for effort.
Yeah, it was something.
Two blocks in a row by Bell. To tie the game, second shot no good. The rebound, though, Lawson State. And Pete Green puts it in to give Lawson the lead. 50-49 with 5:40 to go in the ball game. Bears going to have to keep their composure here. Here's a drive shot. Will not go. And Lawson State with a rebound. Ball's loose on the floor. Let's see. What are they going to say here? Jump ball.
Jump ball.
Possession, Lawson.
Goes to Lawson State.
So the Cougars will have it with 5:28 to go, leading by a point. Miles will inbound. Ball is knocked away from behind. He comes back up with it off the inbound. Bears pressing, still trying to break the timeline. Finally will do so. Here's a bounce pass, right side. On the wing, Williams kicks back out. Purcell with the basketball. Leaves it with Anye. With 10 to shoot, Anye going to pull up, take the three, and connect. 53-49, largest lead of the night now for Lawson State at four. 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Plenty of time. Beckham with the basketball. Near side, three on the way, no good. Ball tipped around, ball still loose. Cam Scott comes back up with the basketball. Leaves it with Beckham, top of the key. 15 to shoot. Cam Scott going to drive baseline, feeds underneath, whistles. What do we have here? Got a foul.
Foul on
Omari P. Green. That'll be his third, eighth team foul. And that's going to send Brian C.J. Grant.
Mm-hmm. 1-1. R.J. Stevens getting ready to check into the game. He's going to hold off, though.
Probably coming in for the shooter. The shot is no good, and we got a whistle. We'll go back the other way. A little too quick in the lane, I guess.
Brett, what's been telling in this game, what we talked about, it's a plus 10 rebounding ratio for Lawson State. Bevill has just, they've just in this quarter have not come up and been more aggressive with grabbing the rebounds.
This is actually going to be a foul on Jordan Bell, and that's going to send Peyton Williams to the line as both teams are in the bonus. So a chance to add to the Lawson State lead. First shot is good.
Substitution for the Bears, number 30,
Malachi Hampton will check in for Maurice Johnson.
And we know the danger of with him. It's four fouls coming in.
Yep. 54-49, 55-49 as he connects with the second shot. Bears need points.
Yes, they do.
4.5 minutes to go in the ball game. Hampton with the basketball. Way outside. Going to leave it with Cam Scott. Scott dribbles, drives. High post. Going to put up the shot. No good. Rolled right out of the rim. No good. And the rebound coming out to Omari P. Green. Ball almost knocked away, but... Lawson going to have it in the front court now. Anya has it. 10 to shoot. He will drive in the paint. Kicks it out. Last moment. Three ball on the way. No good. Yeah. Rebound coming out to Lawson. The offensive board. And the foul underneath on the Bears.
Jordan Bell's getting ready to come back in the game.
That's going to be on C.J. Grant, only his first. But the double bonus is coming up for the remainder of the game for Lawson State. At the charity stripe will be Healy. And he connects with the first.
Grant's going to check out for C.J. Grant.
His third point and another free throw coming up as largest lead of the night for Lawson. Extends to 57-49. Bears have led just about the entire ball game. 3:38 to go in the second half, though. Bell with the basketball. The Bears have been ice cold shooting from the floor here as of late. Need a bucket bad. Beckham going to drive. He's a wide open player underneath. Who will put it up and in? R.J. Stevens.
First points for R.J. of the night.
Makes it a two-possession game, 57-51. But crunch time, as I mentioned, 3:10 to go. Anya with the basketball. He will drive, kick out now. Leaves it off with Omari Peak Green. Picked up by Hampton defensively. He'll drive right past Hampton and dunk the basketball.
They're going to say charge.
Oh,
a charge finally. Jordan Bell put the charge on the dunk. And Omar Pete Green is absolutely incensed. But we've been waiting to see that for a long time, Brett.
Yeah. Through the charge, we look again, you folks, on the video replay. Dunks the ball, but draws the foul. Big play, maybe it'll spark the Bears. Here's a drive. Oh, no. Offensive foul. I knew it was coming.
You got me. I'm going to get you. Mm.
That's going to be on number 15, Cam Scott.
That's four fouls, and it, Brett, that's tough. Cam Scott with 9 points and also 6 rebounds. You don't want to lose him.
Back the other way with the basketball. The ball is almost stolen. Lawson State comes up with it, and now Hampton's going to foul out.
Yep.
Personal foul is foul out of the ball game.
Skylar Heiss is going to check in for Malachi.
Into the game for Bevill State number 2, Skylar Heiss. To the line for Lawson State.
So that's going to send Onye to the lane. He has 8 points.
Timeout.
Timeout Bears will take one as well. 2:27. 2:27 to go in the ball game. We'll be back with more from Lawson State. This is Bear Basketball, presented by Pinnacle Bank. Back in a moment.
Hi, I'm Mason Boren with Twisted Barley Brewing Company in downtown Jasper, and I do all my banking with Pinnacle Bank.
Hi, my name is Sean Doss from the Cigar Box and Goatee Screen Printing downtown Jasper, and my bank is Pinnacle Bank.
I'm Mike Wigginton, principal at H.L. Wigginton Capital Management, and Pinnacle Bank is my bank.
I'm Robin Reed Allen, chairman of the board of Pinnacle Bank. Come see our team and make Pinnacle Bank your bank too.
Welcome back to Birmingham. 57-51. Lawson State with a lead. Out of the timeout here. Heiss is out there. Beckham, Stevens, Scott, and Bell. Your five on the floor for Bevill State Walker College. The Bears have lost 3 in a row, trying to end this skid tonight. They have played a great ball game and led most of the way, but now Lawson State has stormed back to take a 6-point lead. And the shot is good. The free throw is good, 58-51. He'll have another one coming up. Second shot, good. 59-51. Bears going to have points quickly.
Yes, they are.
Beckham leaves it with Heiss. Back over to Bell. Bell going to leave it near side. Ball's in the backcourt. Was it? Nope.
No,
it was
no,
not
no.
touched. Wait a minute. Now another referee is coming saying, I think it was tapped. Let's see. Oh, it will be Bear basketball. It will be Bear basketball. Bell will inbound side court. Inbounds pass, they work it into Beckham. Beckham kick out, Heiss, gonna drive in the paint. On the wing now, shot no good for R.J. Stevens with the rebound, Lawson State, 2 minutes to go. 2 minutes to go, Omari Peak Green with the basketball. Leaves it off with Purcell, who's gonna be fouled by Heiss.
Foul on Bevill State number 2, Skylar Heiss is second. Teams over the limit.
So we got free throws coming up with a minute 53 to go.
For Lawson State, shooting 2.
This is going to be DeMarcus Purcell, the sophomore, averaging 89% from the charity stripe. Team's best free throw shooter, and he nails the first one good.
9-point lead now, Brett.
Yep. Yes, it is. 3-possession game, 4-possession game. Largest lead of the night now for Lawson State at 10. Beckham with a basketball. Going to drive, count it, and the foul.
C.J. Beckham.
C.J. Beckham. Will go to the line to shoot one.
If he can pick up this and one, Brett, he'll be at 20 points on the night.
Well, let's see if he could do it. Shot on the way. It is up. It is no good. Off the back iron. And another foul on Heiss. That'll be Heiss's third. And that's going to send Omari Peak Green to the line. Minute 44 to play. Don't forget to next up for the Bears Monday night against Gadsden State in Birmingham. The Cardinal will be into town. Shot on the way, no good.
Substitution.
Here comes Grant. He's going to check in for Stevens.
So Grant back in the ball game, and the Bears really need some basketball magic now. Back iron, no good. He missed them both. Bears with a chance here to try to cut into this deficit. Going to drive to the bucket. Shot no good, but he's fouled. But the most important thing is, could Beckham connect with the free throws? Can the team connect with the free throws?
Well, we're going to need them both, because otherwise it's going to be really tough with the fact that the Bears are just not coming up with a whole lot of shots right now.
Yeah. Need these free throws. Beckham, no good. No good. A minute 38 to go in the ball game. Second shot on the way. It is no good. And the rebound coming out to Lawson State. It's Pete Green with the basketball. Leaves it with Purcell. Back over now. Kick it out in the front court to Purcell. Picked up by Heiss defensively. Minute 24, clock moving. And another foul, and this one on Heiss again.
Foul on Bevill State number two, Skyler Heiss, is fourth.
Well,
that's his fourth.
Yep.
To the line, shooting two for Lawson State.
You have any eligibility left?
I have never been eligible in basketball, man. I played football, wrestled, and boxed, man.
Yeah. Shot on the way, no good.
But you know, the greatest killer for a basketball team is turnovers and missed free throw shots, and there's been a bunch tonight for the Bears.
Second shot is good. 62-53. In the corner, a three on the way, no good. And the rebound coming out to Lawson State. Cam Scott couldn't connect with the tray, and now the ball into the front court as we are at 1 minute to go in Birmingham.
1 minute to go in the ball game.
9-point lead for Lawson. Way outside, Peak Green with a basketball. Going to drive. Here's a shot in the lane, no good. Fight for the rebound. This is going to be on number 12, C.J. Grant's second. Back to the line is Omari Peak Green, the sophomore. Averaging 17 points a game, Brian.
Yep.
And he has 9 here tonight, make it 10.
He's an 80.6% free throw shooter, which is 6th in the conference. Of course, he's got a buddy that's even better than that.
Yeah, really. Second shot, good.
I'm afraid that's the nail in the coffin.
Yep, 48 seconds to go. Back the other way, Cam Scott with a basketball baseline. He's going to be fouled by number 10. DeMarcus Purcell, that's only his first. So that's going to send Cam Scott to the line. See what Cam can do. Shot on the way. It's no good. I don't know how many free throws we've missed tonight, but
it's been atrocious.
It's a lot. It's been a lot. Second shot is good.
And that's going to be 10 points for Cam.
Inbounds pass, trying to get it inbounds, almost at 5. The double team and the press is on. Long pass out over to Pete Green. He gets into the front court. He will dribble outside and leave it off now with Unyame. 30 seconds to play.
Looks like we got a 10-second differential shot and game clock.
Yeah. 9 to shoot Unyame. He's going to be fouled. This is going to be on Beckham. And with 17 seconds left, it's all over but the crying here. As the Bears going to lose this one, barring some sort of miracle. Shot on the way and good. And now the losing skid at 4 in a row, Brian.
Yep.
And it won't get any easier as Gadsden State comes into town on Monday. Second shot is good. 66-54, 15 seconds to play. Here's Beckham with a basketball, going to put up a tray. It's off the back iron, no good. Long rebound. Cam Scott going to put up the jumper, good. 5 seconds to play. Lawson will inbound, and the clock will expire.
Final score, Lawson State.
Your final score, Lawson State 66. Bevill State Walker College 56 from Birmingham. We're going to take a break. Brian's going to tally up the numbers. We'll be back with the final numbers after this 30-second message from Bevill State Community College.
Your story starts at Bevill State Community College. Whether you are just starting out or starting over, Bevill State has an opportunity that is right for you. With 5 locations serving 7 counties, you don't have to go far to start your own success story. Plus, with tuition lower than 4-year colleges, you won't need to spend more for a great education. Visit us online at bscc.edu to learn about your options for seamless academic transfer and high-demand career tech and health science offerings. Let us help you tell your story.
Welcome back to Birmingham. Your final score, Lawson State 66, Bevill State Walker College 56. Brian, the final numbers.
Well, C.J. Beckham, he did his job tonight. We're at 19 points, 5 rebounds, 2 steals and a block. Cam Scott, 12 points, 7 rebounds and a block. Jordan Bell, nice tidy night, 9 points, 9 rebounds, a steal and a block. And everybody else just kind of meshed around. But, Brett, we know the 3 daggers for tonight, the turnovers, the missed free throws, and team rebounds for Lawson State was 45. Bevill State only had 31. So rebounding differential was a killer.
That's the story of the ball game. Lawson State improves to 12-6 on the season, 6-5 in the conference. Bevill State Walker College, well, we dropped to 5-14 on the season, 2-8 in conference play. Have now lost 4 in a row. Next game up Monday night against Gadsden State Community College there in Jasper at the Clem. So we look forward to seeing you Monday night at home. All right, for Brian Hill, for Sebastian Black, for Woody Wilson, I'm Brett Elmore saying good night from Birmingham.